Hi, Gemini, and welcome to your Zodiac Tarotscope reading. I'm doing things a little different. I'm actually going to be doing two Zodiac Tarotscope readings per month. I'm changing things up a bit, roughly 2 weeks apart. You'll find that this month it will be a little closer because I'm starting so late into the month of February. I'm also going to be doing the cards live as the reading goes. So that's something that I'm changing up as well. So I hope that you enjoy it. We're going to be talking today about your present situation, a snapshot of a present situation or energy that you may be in. And we'll be talking about the past influences as well as the possible future outcome and the focus. So let's get started with the snapshot of the present situation for you, Gemini. In the light of the moon, a full moon can shine light on what you have been resisting. This can be anything from your fears to your soul's beauty. So the message coming in from Spirit here about your current situation is bringing something to light, bringing it out of the shadows, not allowing it to be hidden anymore. But what exactly is that? Let's get some tarot and let's try to get a little more information on it. So what, it's like resisting. What is it resisting? But that big full moon, it can't be hidden for very long. This card came out, the Three of Cups. Oh, this one just keeps sticking out. It didn't come back in. Eight of Wands. Okay. So what we have here, let's just take a good look at this. We're talking about in the light, bringing things to light. Is there something that you've been resisting because you don't want other people to maybe see the success that you've had, or you don't want to publicly celebrate success that you've had in some area of your life? It's almost as though you're trying to keep that. Is there fear around it? I don't know. I feel like this is something that maybe has happened quite recently for you. Whatever this is, regarding celebration or need for celebration, it's something that's happened quickly, maybe quicker than you had anticipated. But for some reason, you're resisting showing it or allowing others to see. So the other part of this is it could be even your fears. Well, that's probably why you're resisting. I would say it's based on fear. But let's look at what past influences could be impacting this also, because there's usually always something from the past that wants to rear its ugly head, right? At times, sometimes it can be good, but we're talking about there's a reason that you're resisting shining light on something, and it looks like it's something that's happened recent or very quickly for you, and it's surrounding some sort of celebration, or maybe it's just an accolade and you know you just don't want people to see. So let's take a look. What could be the past influence or influences that could be mature woman around this. Okay. Let's get some tarot for that too. So is it because whoever this woman is, you don't want them to see that you're doing well for yourself in some area? Or you just know that this person is not going to meet the Knight of Pentacles. They're just not going to be in agreement with it. I'm not sure how this is going to be showing up. And the Four of Pentacles. Okay. just need to get this over a little bit so that you can see it all on camera. Okay, so with the Knight of Pentacles and the Four of Pentacles, the Four of Pentacles is like keeping something close to your chest. Okay, so with this past influence, Gemini, is this maybe something that this woman, we're going to say woman, it could also be a very strong feminine energy in your life. Okay, is this something that maybe, I'm not going to say their idea, but maybe something that they have suggested or wanted you to do? And in the past, you were moving forward on it, but here with the Knight of Pentacles, they're very slow moving of all the knights, right? And they're also very methodical. They're slow and steady. It's almost like you maybe kind of were taking the steps towards it, but you didn't want this person to know. Or whatever it is that this person wanted you to do that could possibly bring success for you or celebration or recognition, whatever it may be, it's almost like there was a price tag attached to it, right? Like, I will help you with this, or I will give you this idea, or I will back it, or whatever it may be, but it needs to be known that this is my idea or my doing or what have you. And you didn't want, you wanted to do it on your own. So I think you've gone ahead and done it on your own. All right. And whatever it was, it's come to fruition very quickly, but you've kind of got this past influence, this person, you're almost, it's like you want to keep it hidden. You're resisting it, right? You're fearful to let them know that you've gone ahead without them. Maybe that's where it's going. You've gone ahead without them. They wanted you to keep it close to your chest as well. And they were keeping it close to theirs because they wanted to maybe do this with you, and you've gone ahead without them. Okay, I kind of see where this could be going. All right, let's look a little deeper here and see what will the possible future outcome be based on this energy or based on this energy. We'll look at it both ways. And this one fell out. Villain. You can always rewrite the story. Okay. Maybe for some of you, what has happened here, it will be different for everyone in your situations, but I keep feeling like this woman, either they backed you in some way, or they wanted to be involved with it. But maybe they are a bit of the villain in the story, right? Like, you know, kind of it's my way or the highway. And if you don't do my way, I'll destroy your highway. Almost that kind of thing. And if you allow this energy here of keeping it secret, right, from this woman because you're afraid or timid or unsure of what their response will be, it's going to hold you back, right? I feel like this is spirit saying you need to, basically, you need to come up out of the depths. You need to, you know, make your jump, right? Be show yourself. Don't let this person rewrite your story, right? Like, don't let them keep you from having your moment because you're afraid of what they might think or how they might react. Okay, let's look at this now with a couple of tarot. If you were to come up out of the depths, if you were to stand in the bright moonlight, if you were not to resist celebrating or showing yourself, you know, whatever this is, okay, whatever this is, it's happened quickly, that maybe you moved forward from this person, slow and steady though, you moved forward and decided, you know, I can do this on my own. We look at it that way. So let's see here with some tarot. Gemini, this is very interesting. Okay, Two of Wands. All right. With the Star. Okay. All right. So if you, I love this. I just got goosebumps. If you choose to move forward, okay, not worrying about what's here. We look at this now. You're leaving the villain behind. Okay. And the villain could be the secret, the trying to keep it secret or hidden. Okay. It may not be necessarily the person. It can be that energy of the secret, trying to keep something hidden. But they're saying you can always rewrite the story. If something good has happened for you quickly, it's time for celebration. You can always rewrite the story. You just tell the truth. In the beginning, yes, I was in cahoots or whatever it was with this person, or they were there to support me. And, you know, but I knew I couldn't move forward with them past that phase, okay, or that part. So I slowly moved forward on my own. I feel like honesty is the best policy here. I feel like you need to see that this is the time for the sun to shine down on you. Okay, this is time for you to carve your own path, make your own plans, do what it is that you need to be doing that's going to keep everything above board and in the light. You were meant to shine here, okay? You were meant with the star. I love this because it's trusting that one, spirit, God, source, universe has your back and will help you move through this. But it also lets you know that there is balance that can be found in this situation. There doesn't need to be fear and secrecy. You can move forward and the balance will be found. And I think that balance is in truth. That's what I'm hearing very strongly from them. The balance will be found in truth. Almost like you can rewrite the story, but you rewrite it truthfully, I guess, in the sense, or maybe it even means, I don't know, I'm kind of feeling like you don't have to rewrite anything. You just tell the truth. Okay. And then you will be able to move forward. Now, the next couple of things that we're going to look at here. Yeah. And the star is just, again, I always think of the star as, you know, it's your hopes and dreams have come true. You have been true and authentic to yourself and you did move forward with this. And so it's meant to be a time to shine, right? That's what I kind of feel that's what it's trying to say here. Now, we're going to look at two more cards and some more tarot, but we're going to look at what do you need to shift your focus from in order to move past this energy. I almost feel like this is a haunting energy. I feel that this person is still here, maybe. Oh, it's funny that I said it like that. Or is it, for some of you, could it be, oh gosh, okay. What just popped into my mind? It's like a long lost family recipe that you have now taken and made for your own. So it could be like a haunting. There's a reason I said a haunting energy. So for some of you, yes, the person is still here. For others of you, I almost feel like they're not. This is something that you moved forward on, like for example, a long lost family recipe. And hey, you're having success with it, but and everybody thinks that it's your own, but I don't know, you for some reason you feel you can't say it's a long lost family recipe, if that makes any sense. Okay, so there's that, but you're meant to shine and this is meant to be successful. And like, look, there's even the little musical notes here, right? I just feel like, even though she's the villain who I feel is gonna smash that, we're not going to look at that. But like I said, this energy, this woman could be the villain that wants to smash it. And that's what you're afraid of. If they find out, they're going to really cause a problem. But I don't think so. I think the truth prevails here. That's what spirit is very strong about. The truth prevails. All right, let's get a card for an energy that you need to remove your focus from. Okay, hope. Well, I think that's very simple. First thing that came in was hoping that it's just going to disappear on its own, hoping that this will just take care of itself in a good way. Look, the sun shining, everything will be fine. No, I think there is action that you do have to take, which is you need to come clean. You need to stand out in the spotlight, okay, with it. You just can't leave it and hope that all works out well. There is action that needs to be taken on your part. Judgment. Yeah, I love the way these cards come out. With the judgment card is, I feel this is just a message from Spirit saying, if you shift your focus from hoping that this will all just work out on its own, that there will be no judgment, what have you, that really isn't going to happen. You need to take the steps. You need to step out into the light. And again, that is where judgment will not happen, okay? Where you, again, I just keep coming back to the truth will set you free here. The truth will be understood. So I feel that when they say you need to not focus on the hope that it's just going to resolve itself, that's basically it. They're not saying give up on hope. Spirit's never going to tell you that, right? But they are going to say you may have to look at things a little bit differently here. Now, let's get a card here for what you should focus on. Where should you put your focus? Get it off of the hope that it's going to resolve itself, okay? That's wishful thinking. All right. What does this say? Temptation. Ooh, I like this. Temptation with, let's get a tarot. Not doing very good at shuffling today, everyone. The cards just aren't working with me here. Okay, we're going to go with this one because it was kind of turning. Temperance. This is the Devil card, right? 15 shows up as the Devil card. They want you to focus on breaking free of the temptation of keeping it a secret. They want you to focus on breaking free from this past energy. They want you to focus on what good this is going to bring into your life, that this is your time to shine, that this is your story. You don't have to rewrite anything. There we go. That this is your time to let the spotlight shine on you, to carve your own path. They want you to break free and focus on not allowing temptation to just hope that this will all go away on its own. They're saying balance can be had here, okay? There is balance to be had. That's what temperance is. Temperance is realizing that balance can be had. It's realizing that, oh, something interesting, that you can take what is from the past and bring it through to your future. Remember I was saying, like, it could be like some sort of old family, I don't know, the way you did something, like I'd use baking as an example, an old family recipe, and all of a sudden it's just blowing up, right? Maybe you do it on YouTube, something like that. And they're saying, so something from the past can be used for something good in the future. It's finding the balance there. Ooh, I like this message for you, Gemini. Now let's get a couple more tarot just for further guidance, clarification, confirmation of outcome here. Three of Swords. I'm just going to get one more. Oh, geez, that's way too many. Let me just turn them around. Told you today's not my good shuffling day. Okay, that one, the Hangman. Yeah. I feel like what they're saying here is there could be some past energies that are feeling hurt. Maybe if this person is still around, they're going to feel like they've been, you know, stabbed in the heart type of thing. They're going to feel the pain, emotional pain, because you moved on without them. Yes, there is a possibility of that. But again, there, I just keep seeing the blue in the cards. The truth is going to be your salvation, your savior in this, right? The Hanged Man. Again, just take your time. See things from a different perspective. When it comes to how it is you're going to allow yourself to step out and shine here, because that does need to happen. They're saying you don't need to move quickly on it. You can take a little bit of time here. You can see things from a different perspective. Maybe see how with the thought and caring, because I feel that you do have empathy for this situation and you want to do it in the right way. And maybe that's why they're saying take a little bit of time here, even with temperance, take your time. Okay. Judgment, take your time. And the Knight of Pentacles here, taking your time. And even here, taking your time to plan, see how it's coming out in all the different cards, holding it close to your chest. If we want to just look at them individually, this is taking your time and realizing that there is a way to do this, which maybe won't cause as much pain, or where maybe there won't be as much conflict, okay, on an emotional side of things. So that is your main message. Although I feel like I just want to pull, and I haven't done this, Gemini. I feel like there's one more card here that needs to come out. Like there's something else. One more card. There we go. Yeah, okay. Just confirming it. Take the time to hermit away. You may need to do that first. I feel like you've already been doing it because you've been resisting it, right? But I feel when we say resisting, that was resisting the thought of even doing it at all, okay? And they're saying, no, you need to let yourself shine. But take that little bit of time out just to confirm here with what I was saying with the Hangman. You know, go within. Go to the light within, right? Figure out how you can do this, which will cause the least amount of pain or anguish or what upset for everyone. And that is the way. Make the plan and move forward. Okay? Because if you do that, you have a wonderful future outcome. Okay? You will be standing in your own spotlight. All right, Gemini, that is your reading. I hope that you enjoyed it. If you like this new format, by all means, please throw me that thumbs up. Leave a comment. That would be great as well. And I will see you probably in a week or so with your next reading.